Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial, and this is the series then where we are going to learn about how to use the edit text button along with the text view. We have already discussed about the text view and the button, and the next guy is going to be the edit text. So edit text is nothing but something that we give an input text. For the example, we have the plain text, password, password numeric, email, phone, and all these things are edit text. This is the example for edit text. So I'm just dragging the plain text into the layout. We have the edit text with a text view, and I also want to add a button into it. So I'm adding a button here. Okay, so what I'm going to do today is that when the user give an input text into this edit text, and when the user press the button, the edit text or the value of the edit text will be passing to the text view. So what we have to do is we have to simply mention some ID. So we already have seen here is the text view, edit text, and button as the ID for each widgets. Now let's move on to the main activity. I'm just going to implement and cast the edit text and the three things here. Okay, so we have implemented the three things inside the one create method. If you guys don't know what I actually done here, you probably watched the previous series. So now when the user type inside the edit text and press the button, it should pass the edit text value into this text view. So I'm going to add a button click listener for this button. So button dot set one click listener, set one click listener, new one click listener. Okay, so first I'm going to get the value from the edit text into a string. So we have already learned about what is string, and if you guys don't know, then probably watch the previous episode. I'm going to add a string, then I'm naming the string as et string equal to edit text dot get text, then toString. Okay, so now we have implemented a new string here with the name etString, and it actually get the value from the edit text into that string, and it and now what we have to do is that we have to pass the value from the string into the text view when the button is clicked. So I'm adding a text view dot set text, and string name, that is etString. Now we have completed. This is actually a simple project, and my goal is to just teach you guys that how to get the value from the edit text into the string, and then passing the string value into that text view. Now let's move on to the main activity, and there's nothing here. Okay, so you can see here it is the Android input text equal to text person name. So this can actually you use it to give a specific name with anything as you want. But in case of the, let me show you, type equal to, so we have a different kind of mode of text that can be entered into this edit text. We have the plain text, and then date, which is going to be numeric, and date time, which is also going to be numeric with some other symbols and other things, and none, which is going to be nothing, and the number, number decimal, number password, number signed, phone, and many other things. So according to the type of edit text that you are choosing, your keyboard and some other things will be automatically changing according to that. And for example, if you're using the edit text verb email address, then your Android on-screen keyboard will be having a at symbol inside that, and likewise, and many other things we can see. And if you're using the password like that, this one, the edit, the text password, if you're using the text password, it will automatically just hide the all the text that you entered into this edit text. And likewise, you can perform many other things with that. I'm going to set it into text itself for this. Okay, so here is the text that you can able to give by default into this edit text. And if you want to remove that, and let me show you how to add a hint, Android hint. So hint is going to be something that says like enter your name. So this is actually a kind of hint that it won't be able to edit this text, but the user can able to read this until he types something inside this edit text. So now let's go and run it in a live device and check that out. Okay, so here is the Android app in the Android device. Now I'm trying to type something into this edit text. Okay, now let's press the button and bam, you can see the edit text value has been passed into the text view. So that's for the tutorial. So I hope you guys enjoy watching this tutorial, and if you like this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, do it now. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next tutorial.